Today, I'm going to show you the current state of my Raspberry Pi wearable computer that I'm currently wearing right now, and I'm also going to describe a little bit about what I'd like to do in the future.
Here's the computer itself. Around it, you will notice the power cable that can be easily disconnected, and you unplug it from both boxes. I'm going to disassemble it so you can see how it's made. I held the battery pack to the Raspberry Pi with rubber bands so it doesn't have to go in your pocket like the last version. I also found that the Velcro straps that I was using in the last version were not as good for putting things together, and they can also be a pretty big problem when you're wearing with clothing. I managed to stuff a 5-volt charge controller and 4 AA battery holders in an Altoids tin, along with attaching a power switch to the side. The Raspberry Pi itself lacks a power switch, so that's a good addition to have as well. That's the battery pack, and now we're going to take a look at the Pi itself. The Raspberry Pi is placed in a case that I printed from a design I found on Thingiverse. It has a belt clip so you can attach it to your waist for easy carrying around. There's my Wi-Fi adapter and keyboard connector. I put some heat sinks on it as well, just to help things stay cool, although it is meant to be worn on your waist, so it allows it to vent easily. Now I'm going to show you a look at what it's like behind the screens. So first we have to hit the power switch on the Pi, and you'll be able to see the light come on through the plastic case. And I also have to turn on the video glasses because they're powered by a separate power pack. Raspberry Pi is going to boot up, and it's going to be a little hard to show you this on camera, but it is currently booting. And you can see the Raspberry in the top left corner of the screen, as well as the log outputs. The UI is loaded, and you can see the mouse is on the screen. We're at our desktop, and I'm going to open the web browser Midori so you can see what it's like to use the computer through the screen. There it goes, and we're going to be on the Raspberry Pi Quick Start Guide page. It might not look so great through the camera, but again, you can read the text while wearing the glasses, and if need be, you can increase the font size, you can change font colors so that they're easier to read over the background, especially on the taskbar, and I did that on the desktop, and I made the font a off-white color, so you can see it against the black background. And that's my wearable computer.
So there are definitely a lot of improvements that can be made. I want to consolidate the actual Pi box and the video glasses box into one system. I want to make it more compact, and then eventually my newer design will have a single wire going out connecting to the glasses. I'm going to tinker a little with these glasses to see if maybe we can make them a little smaller. Some people on Instructables also suggested that we use cameras in the front to make a more augmented reality experience. As you noticed when I showed you inside the glasses, you cannot currently see behind them. You can see around the lens, but you can't see directly in front of you. And that's a little bit of a problem if you intend to walk with these. I advise you don't do that because you might find yourself walking into walls. I'm going to switch to a lithium-ion battery pack. I've been investigating that a little, and it seems like that'll make a slimmer design. It'll be easier to charge, and in addition to being easier to charge, it might even have a higher capacity than what I've gotten here right now. And I'm going to design a new enclosure. The current Pi enclosure is actually something I got off of Thingiverse, and I've linked to that in my Instructable. But I'm going to modify that to have room for the batteries and room for this as well. I'm hoping that I can figure out how to charge this with a slim lithium-ion pack as well, and that would greatly aid the carry-around ability. That's not a word. The carry-aroundness, that's also not a word. I'm going to carry it around. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.